If f of x is negative, increasing, and concave down, then the antiderivative function, big F of x, is one of the following: decreasing and concave up, decreasing and concave down, increasing and concave down, or increasing and concave up. Let's begin by reviewing the definition of the antiderivative function. Big F of x is an antiderivative of small f of x if big F prime of x equals small f of x. So notice how here, when we're given information about f of x, we can think of this as information about big F prime of x. Again, because big F of x is the antiderivative of f of x, its derivative equals small f of x. So to begin, we're told that f of x is negative, which means big F prime of x is negative, and the sign of the first derivative indicates whether a function is increasing or decreasing. So because big F prime of x is negative, big F of x would have to be decreasing. So again, if f of x is negative, which equals big F prime of x, this indicates that big F is decreasing. Remember, our goal here is to indicate which of these is true about big F of x. Next, we're told that f of x is increasing. Well, if f of x is increasing, then f prime of x would have to be positive. And if f prime of x is positive, then big F double prime of x would also be positive. So again, f prime of x equals big F double prime of x, which we know is positive. And the second derivative indicates concavity. So because the second derivative of big F is positive, this means big F of x would have to be concave up. If the second derivative was less than zero or negative, that means big F would be concave down. And we're also told that f of x is concave down. Well, if f of x is concave down, that means the second derivative of f, which is actually the third derivative of big F, would have to be negative. But this information is actually not needed to answer the question. We now know that big F is decreasing and concave up, and therefore our answer is this first choice here, decreasing and concave up. Let's finish by sketching a possible graph for big F of x. Because big F is decreasing, we know as x increases, y decreases, or the function must go downhill from left to right. And if the function is concave up, it must resemble at least a piece of a graph that looks like this. But again, because our function is decreasing, it will only resemble the left side of this graph that's concave up. So big F of x could look something like this. Notice how the function is decreasing and concave up. I hope you found this helpful.